हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम यू ऑल ऑन यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ चमेली देवी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मेसी इंदौर. सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ कैटेगरी ऑफ मोनोफेजिक लिक्विड डोजेस फॉर्म, दैट इज़ लिक्विड टू बी अप्लाइड टू द स्किन, फॉर एग्जांपल लिनिमेंट एंड लोशन. सो इन दिस सेशन वी विल डिस्कस general introduction of liniment and lotion, type of liniment and use of liniment, with packaging and storage condition of liniment. Similarly, introduction about lotion, formulation consideration of lotion, packaging and storage condition of lotion. So let's start it. So what is liniment? So liniments are liquid or semi-liquid preparation meant for external use or meant for application to the skin. These are alcoholic or oleaginous solution or emulsion of various medicinal substances intended to be rubbed on the skin. So liniments are usually applied to the skin with friction and rubbing of the skin. Liniments should not be applied on broken skin because it may cause irritation to the skin. So basically liniments are the preparation that may be liquid or semi-liquid are intended for external application or application to the skin. These are the solution or mixture of various substances in oil or alcoholic solution of soap or emulsion, and they may contain suitable antimicrobial agent or preservative. Liniment preparation are applied with friction and rubbing of the skin, but they should not be applied on broken skin because they may cause irritation. Now the use of liniment. So generally liniments contain medicament possessing analgesic, antipruritic, counter irritant, rubefacient and emollient properties. So first is analgesic liniment used to relieve the pain. Next is antipruritic used to relieve itching. Counter irritant liniments are applied locally to produce superficial inflammation with the object of reducing inflammation in deeper adjacent structure. Next is rubefacient. So rubefacients are the substances that cause redness or rubor. And the last application or use of liniment is emollient. So emollient, that means produce that soften skin or treat dry skin. So these are the use of liniment or application of liniment. Now the type of liniment. As we know, liniments are solution or mixture of various substance in oil or alcoholic solution of soap, emulsion. So on the basis of these solvent or basis or vehicle for liniment, they are classified into two classes. First is oleaginous liniment and next is alcoholic liniment. So in oleaginous liniment, the vehicle is oil based. So example of these type of oils, some may be fixed oils such as almond oil, peanut oil, sesam oil or cottonseed oil, or a volatile oil such as wintergreen oil or turpentine oil may be used. So oleaginous liniments are less irritating to the skin than alcoholic liniment. Next is, because of greater spreadability of oleaginous liniment, so they are mostly used or employed primarily when massage is desired. And due to high penetration power of alcohol. So alcoholic liniments are useful when rubefacient, counter irritant or penetration action is desired. And the third one is less penetration than alcohol. So alcoholic liniment having more penetration power than oleaginous liniment. Now the example of liniment. So here we have taken example of turpentine liniment. So prepare and dispense 100 ml turpentine liniment IP. So ingredients are soft soap 9 gram, camphor 5 gram, turpentine oil 65 gram, purified water 100 ml. So for the formulation of turpentine liniment, first of all we have to mix the soap solution with a small quantity of purified water. Then prepare a solution of camphor in freshly rectified turpentine oil. Then gradually add the camphor solution to the soap mixture with trituration or stirring with the glass rod till a thick creamy emulsion is formed. Add sufficient purified water to produce the required volume. Then mix it thoroughly and transfer the preparation to a bottle and label, then dispensed. After the formulation, the container should be colored fluted bottle in order to distinguish it from preparation meant for internal use. After filling the preparation in container, next step is labeling. So labeling must state for external use only and shake well before use. The label should also carry the warning not to be applied to the open wound or broken skin, as we discussed on previous first introduction slide of liniment. So we can also use the warning on the label, that is not to be applied to open wound or broken skin. And the last is storage of liniment. So liniment should be stored in tightly closed, airtight or well closed container, airtight container, and stored in cool place. After liniment, the lotion is the one of the example of liquid means for external use. So definition of lotions is liquid or semi-liquid preparation that contain one or more active ingredient or medicament in an appropriate vehicle, and these preparation meant for external use. So lotions are liquid preparation meant for external application without friction. So there is no need of rubbing or friction. Lotion can be applied on broken skin. Lotions used as antiseptic, astringent, germicidal action. So basically lotions are applied direct to the skin with the help of some absorbent material such as cotton, grease soaked, and lotion may be used for local action as cooling, soothing and protective purpose, but they are generally used or applied for antiseptic action, astringent action and germicidal action. So example of most famous lotion is calamine lotion. Now the formulation consideration of lotion. So the components of lotions are, first is alcohol. Alcohol is act as a coolant due to evaporation following application or evaporation during application, and It is also act as a co-solvent for other ingredient. So alcohol is sometimes included in aqueous solution for its cooling and soothing effect. Next component of lotion is humectant. So humectant are used to retain the moisture on the skin after application. The most commonly used example is glycerol. So alcohol having two role in lotion. First is coolant or soothing action. Next is work as a co-solvent. And next component is humectant, which helps to retain the moisture on the skin. And example of humectant is glycerol or glycerin. Now the next component or important component of lotion is vehicle. So lotions are aqueous formulation and therefore will contain purified water with or without the addition of buffer salt. Buffer salt used to achieve the pH similar to the skin. Sometimes some component to stabilize the suspended therapeutic agent is required if the lotion has been formulated as a suspension. So suspending agents are required to maintain the physical stability of the formulation or suspension. So sometimes natural gums are used as a suspending agent in lotion formulation. So lotion can be formulated as suspension or solution form. So after the formulation, the lotion should be dispensed in colored fluted bottle in order to distinguish them from preparation meant for internal use, because lotion is used as externally or to the skin. After the filling lotion into the container, the labeling of container should be done. So the container should be labeled for external use only. Sometimes on standing lotion have a tendency to separate out, therefore the container must be labeled sake well before use. And after the labeling, storage of lotion, so lotion container should be stored in well filled, well closed and in airtight container in a cool place. Thank you.